What are you currently reading?
Well, I brought it with me, Vladimir Nabokov's memoir with the great title, Speak, Memory. I love books about people's past, about their childhood, about their memories. I guess because I write for kids, I want to know what kids are like, and I think there's a continuity to that. I mean, Nabokov is long dead, and he was born way long ago, but nonetheless, his childhood in another country, in Russia, still speaks to the whole world of childhood for me.
If you could choose to live in any fictional world, where would it be and why?
Well, I'm real nerdy this way. I would choose the world of Jane Austen. I know my kids would die of measles, when they're three, but forgetting that, I like the world of manners. Also, I think the clothes are terrific, but I've been influenced by film, I think, on that one.
What was your favorite children's book?
When I was a child, there was a well-known author named Lois Lenski, and because her name was the same as mine, she became my favorite. My favorite of her books was one called Indian Captive, which was based on the real story of a child in upstate New York who had been captured by Indians and lived with them for many years. And I just became that child and loved that book, even though she wrote other books that were more popular and more highly regarded, one that won the Newbery Medal. I loved Indian Captive. Every now and then a kid at that pivotal age of 12 or 13 when they're turning into adults will say that something of mine that they've read has changed how they think about things. I mean, that's what I try to do, and it's why I feel such an enormous responsibility to the audience.
Why is censorship so dangerous?
I actually, in the book, The Giver, it makes clear why censorship is so dangerous, and it's ironic that that book is the most frequently censored of my own books. The world of The Giver, set in a future time, has no books. It has no literature. They've been removed one by one gradually over the course of many generations because it's an attempt to keep people happy and comfortable and make them feel safe. And so anything that might make people uncomfortable is removed. And there goes illness, war, anything that puts the passion into literature is gone. And so it emerges a world, a community, where there is no art, no music, and no literature.
That's
very dangerous.